In the last class, we draw this button down shirt and we forget to add yoke. So first I add yoke and it's a group. So we have to open this on the temporary basis. So double click and then choose line tool and create a intersecting line. And then switch to selection tool and create a duplicate copy in the right side by using reflect tool. Alt click on the center line, copy, vertical is already selected, and join them by using shift key. I select both line, right click, join. Now I divide this shirt body by using this line. Line is selected and there is no fill color. If there is any color, so it will create problem. So make sure there is no fill color. Now I select shirt body by pressing shift key and then apply divide tool. So I click on the three dot and click on the divide. Divide tool apply on the shirt body. Now I change the order. So first click outside, then select again, then right click, arrange and send to back. There is one more problem in the collar. From this area, backside of this shirt will show and it should be gray. So I choose collar and then double click because it's a group. And then create a triangle here by using pen tool. Or you can switch to outline mode. So you can create a pixel perfect point. Okay, and then switch to GPU preview mode and fill with gray color. Okay, so problem solved. Double click outside to exit from the editing mode. In the t-shirt drawing class, we learned how to add a stitching line. So I add a stitching line and then continue. Front of this button down shirt is complete now. Now I create backside of this shirt. So first I create a duplicate copy by pressing Alt and Shift key, and by using this front I create backside. First I double click and delete unused part like these buttons and placket. Double click and we are in editing mode and delete this placket. Stitching lines and move these buttons outside. Ungroup and delete selected button, and this button I use for cuff. Now I select shirt body and it's a group, so double click and select this yoke. By pressing shift key, select shirt body and then unite and select this stitching line and delete because it's not useful now. Yoke is deleted now. Now I merge this collar with the shirt body. So double click again and then select this collar. By pressing shift key, select this shirt body and then unite. So it will merge now and change the fill color. Now I make some changes. I create a line here to divide this collar and shirt body and create a yoke line here by using line tool. By pressing shift key, you can create a straight line and zoom little bit and modify. Okay, I think there is some problem. So I move this upside and delete this extra point by using pen tool. And place this line on the proper position. And create another line for yoke. Now I select all three shapes and then apply divide tool. Divide tool is applied now. Click outside first and then select, right click, arrange and send to backward. I add a stitching line here, so I switch to direct selection tool. Select this node, Ctrl C, Ctrl F, move upside by using arrow key and then pick this stroke parameter by using eyedropper tool. So I click on the stitching line. So this property will copy here. Same as I add a stitching line here. So I select this stroke first. Control C, Control F, and then move in the downside. Choose eyedropper tool again. And then pick stroke properties. Okay. Same as you can also add a stitching line here, or you can manually create by using line tool. Double click outside to exit from the editing mode. Now I create a placate here. So double click and create a rectangle. Change the stroke parameter. Now I create a point in center by using pen tool and create a triangle effect. Now I delete this segment. So I select this and then delete. For creating a stitching line, I create a copy and then scale down. So Control C, Control F, then scale down by pressing Alt key and pick the stroke parameter. Now I move this little bit down by using arrow key and then select this point and then move downside. So deselect first and then select again and then move little bit upside. Okay, so stitching line is created. By clicking on this icon, you can fix the problem if you face on the corner. Okay, like this. Now I make a group and then place here. Rotate this little bit. You can also use rotate tool. It's also available here. So click here because it's a pinpoint, and by using this pinpoint we rotate this. I think there is a fill color, so click on the none color. Okay, and move little bit upside. Now I make some changes. I extend this line by using direct selection tool and then click to select this point first and then extend. Okay, same as I extend this stitching line, click to select first and then move. I think click point is selected now and then click and drag. Okay, and then select this button and move here. Now this sleeve is created. Now I delete this and replace with this. So I select this and then click on the center by using Alt key, copy, double click to exit from the editing mode. So backside of this shirt is complete now. Now I hide this template. So I go to layer tab and then hide this template layer. And then place in a proper way. Okay, or you can also place like this and then scale up. It's a final view of our button down shirt. I hope you like this.